pressure networks in CO3D tend to be networks such as water supply networks or gas networks. So here in this drawing, we have a line here that represents a water supply pipe. So this is an estate, as you can see. We have various parcels of land, and then we have a pipe that is flowing, that is passing on their frontage, that is representing the pipe that will be supplying all these lands with water. So there'll be connections to premises from this main line in this estate. So water is coming all the way from this side, flowing this way. And in pressure networks, it doesn't matter the terrain or the topography, as long as the pressure is enough to flow upwards or downwards. So if the pressure is enough in the pipe, the water can flow upwards. We know for pipe networks we have to have a slope for the water or the sewer or the storm to flow. But for pressurized systems, if the pressure is enough, if the pressure from the pump is enough, if the pressure head from the other portions of the pipeline is pushing the water to up the hill, the water will flow. Yeah, so let's look at how we design a pipe or a pressure pipe network. So the first thing you get to do is you go to the Create Design panel. Let me escape first. You go to the Create Design panel, and then you set the pressure network catalog. So here you come and set the pressure network catalog. You'll see a folder within your computer where you have various catalogs. Let me see whether I can get a metric. I see for pressure networks, we only have the imperial. So that's okay. This is where the folder resides. And then you have a catalog database file. So you have different types of files. So you're going to load a pipe of choice, a material of choice. Nowadays, there are various materials for pipe networks. There is HDPE, there is GI pipes, there is steel pipes, there is PVC. All those pipes are used for example, for water supply. A common pipe that is being used nowadays in the market is this HDPE pipe. So let's try it out. So I click on HDPE and go and click OK. So I've set up my pipe network catalog here at the extension of the Create Design panel. So here I set my pressure network catalog. Then the next thing I want to do is to create a parts list. So for the parts that are going to be used, we know that a pipe network or a pressure network usually has different components. So you have the pipe itself, then at the junctions you usually have a fitting. A fitting can be a T, for example, at this junction. You can see this forms a T. This is a, this looks like a T, a letter T. So this is a T junction. So you need a fitting for you to connect this pipe and this pipe going upward. And then where the pipe is bending, you also need bends. Some people in other countries call them elbows. For you to connect the two pipe runs that are connecting, or the two straights. So let's create our parts list. Another component of the parts list is the appurtenances. Appurtenances consist of valves, air valves, and all that. And we know in pipe networks we usually have our air valves at the crest of the pipe network, so that they can release air when air accumulates into the network. So let's go. Let's create the parts list. So how do we do that? So here there's a parts list that I already created. If we edit it, we can see what it consists of. So for the pressure pipe, it consists of a half inch, three quarter inch, 1 inch pipes, and 2 inch, 3 inch, and all that. So let's just create it afresh. Let's see, how do we create? We just come to the pass list. We come to the settings tab. Don't go to the prospector tab. Just go to the settings tab. Then navigate your way down to the pressure network. You'll see, if you expand the pressure network, you'll see pass list. Then select the pass list, right click, and create a new one. So here at the information tab, you'll first name your pass list. You can call it water supply to a state. That's okay. Then I'll go to the pressure pipe tab. So this is where you add a material. So if you want to supply this place with HDPE pipe, which we had already selected as our pipe material, just come here and click OK. Then you can expand. You'll see a plus sign there. You can expand these pressure pipes. Then here you can add sizes. So I want to add all the sizes. And I click OK. So let's see all the sizes that have been added. So here we have a half inch, three quarter inch. I know we are in metric regions, but even in metric regions, you realize that pipes are also referred to in these imperial units. So sometimes it's not strange when you go and ask a pipe supplier, can you supply me with half inch, can you supply me with three quarter inch, even though you are in a metric country. So these are HDPE pipes, but they are being reported in imperial units. Then you have this SDR. This is just a ratio. It's usually a ratio between the pipe diameter and the pipe thickness. So the smaller it is, it means it's a higher pressure rating. So it means the pipe is thick, so it's a higher pressure rating. So if you have SDR 11, this is probably a PN16, and then SDR 9 could be even a higher pressure rating. Then if you go to the next tab, here we can add the fittings. The fittings, as we said, are T's, elbows, reducers, and all that. So let's add type. I want to add across, because not across, I want to add a T. Let me just add all of them. You can have an end cap or a plug where you terminate your pipe and you don't want to go further, you just cap it. So that's the fitting. So we click OK, and now for the elbows, let's see, add size. I want to add all sizes. Let me see what we have here. So we have different types of elbows. We have our bends. We have 11.25 degree bends. We have 22.5 degree bends. We have 45 degree bends. And we have them in different sizes. I see here we have them in 3 inch. So if your catalog is limited, you can go again to the catalog and add other pipe sizes or other pipe material so that you can have other range of sizes. So I know I'll need a T here. So let me add size. Let me add all sizes and click OK. All right. Then, let me work with elbows and T's for now. Then appurtenances, I will add some add type. And I want to add gate valves only for now. Add the gate valves. All right. So gate valves, the closed and open networks. So let's say you want to close out this other side. Probably you have a gate valve here. You want to do maintenance downstream. So water will be flowing from this side going this way. So if you want to do some maintenance downstream, you just close the gate valve and you do your maintenance downstream. So that's the reason for the gate valves. And then here you have your summary and all that. So now that we've set up our pass list, let's apply it and let's click OK. So now we can create our pressure network. So how do we do that? We already have a pass list called water supply to estate. Let's come all the way here. Let's come to the create design panel here at pipe networks. There are pipe networks and then there are pressure networks. So we are creating pressure networks and we want to create from objects. So we're creating from these two objects. This polyline is coming all the way down. So we have a pipe on the road reserve. And then we also have a pipe on the road reserve down here. So we want to come all the way down here. So we create pressure network from object. We just click that and we select the object. So don't worry about the other object. So here. Okay. Let me escape first. Pipe network. Create pressure network from object. So you select the object. So I'm asked whether I want that direction. So let's see. So I don't want that direction. I reverse. And then I hit enter. When I reverse, I hit enter. This create pressure network window will pop up. So by pressure network window, I call it estate, water supply. Then pipe run name, it will be named as pipe run 1, 2, 3, and so on and so forth. So my pass list is different. It's what I created. It's not the standard pass list. It's the water supply to estate. Then for the pipe size, I want to go with a 3-inch. A 3-inch is basically an OD90 or a nominal diameter 75 millimeters. We know an inch is equal to 25 millimeters. So 3-inch is an OD90, not a very big pipe. This is a standard pipe. So we'll go with the SDR11, probably a PN16. But in water supply up to the estate level, you'll probably do a SDR17, which is a PN10. But let's go with the one which is available in the catalog. So something else that you can set up is the layers. Here you can see you can set up the layers for everything, for the pipeline, for the fittings. So let's just go with the defaults for now. Let's click OK. And then the reference surface, let's go with the existing ground. So we create surface profile to follow. We'll create a surface profile for that. That's OK. And then for the horizontal offset from an alignment, we are not choosing an alignment yet. So let's just go with not choosing an alignment. And then for the elevation reference, so the cover, we are choosing 1 meter depth. This will vary according to the specifications of your country or your state or your county, all that will inform. But the manual also from your country can inform what is the specification for the cover. So what this means is that from the ground level, the pipe will be buried 1 meter deep into the ground. So that's the cover. So cover on top of the pipe is 1 meter ground. The reason why we do this is because we want to have the pipe safely buried down there, away from any physical damage that may be subjected to the pipe. So let's click OK. Once we do that, and there we go. We notice that this is a pipe now. This is a pipe that has been created. So let's even look at it. Let's click it and look at it at on profile view. So let's create a profile run. Let's create a new profile and click OK. Let's create a profile view here and see how the pipe behaves. So there we go. As you can see, yeah, the pipe is buried 1 meter below. So let's try as much as possible to follow the ground terrain. I know at some points it will not be possible, but this can be edited. But the pipe run is trying as much as possible to follow the 1 meter depth that we assigned it. So here we can create another bend. We can edit that in the video where we'll do the pipe edits. So I want to continue building my network. Remember, we have this other network that is going all around the estate. So supplying each house, cross, and just next to the frontage. So you can either have two pipes going this way and this way, so that we cover the two frontages. But let's work with this one for now. So I want to add this one to the existing network, the water supply to the estate. So I click on a pipe. So let me escape first. Let me click on the pipe that we had created. And then I want to add new pipe run. So I want to create run from object. So I just click that and then I select the object. So let me see where the pipe is flowing. It's flowing okay. I want it to flow this way and come and form a loop. So I just click OK. And then I use the defaults. This is what we had assigned even in the other pipe. So I just click OK. Now, as you can see, we have a pipe. And it's been now included in the network. So we want to create a T here. So we want to create a T junction. So first of all, I will move this junction. Remember, that pipe was forming a loop. So this pipe was forming a loop. So I want just to move. Sorry, let me move this up. Let me put off snap and move it. Okay, so I want to join these two pipes. Let me join them. As you can see, there's a glyph there. Once I join them like that, automatically a T is created in between the two pipes. Okay. And if there are different levels, the levels are matched automatically. So that's the beauty of having pressure networking in Civil 3D. So let's have a look at this. Let's have a look at this in Project Viewer. Let's look at this. As you can see, everything is neat in Civil 3D, in 3D. So this is a pipe in 3D. This is a T in 3D, you can see. So everything is working out all right. So this is the introduction to the pipe network. This is how you do it. It's pretty simple. So if you like the video, please remember to like. Please remember to share. Share with your friends. Share with your colleagues if it is of help to them. So if you have any questions, please remember to type them out in the comment section. Also, if you have better ways of doing the same thing, please also comment. And if there's any other material you would like us to cover, please also remember to share with us in the comment section. So until next time, please stay safe and let's meet again.